Okay, so that's Faisal. All right. So Faisal, that's the very first session. Can you change your name to your name, please? That would be some. Or last time also I did tell you, how do you change your name? Okay. By just going into preferences, Faisal, you can do that. So go on to preferences and then into general settings. You'll get to see the settings where you can change your name, Faisal. All right, great. So we have Faisal from New Delhi. We have Kaushal from Bangalore. And then we have Kumar Swami. Yeah, Faisal. So we perfectly fine. Thank you so much. So hi, Kumar. Good evening. Hi, Santosh, Kaushal, Faisal. So guys, let's get started. I just wanted to understand from you as well, Kumar, what background are you from? We have just done the introduction part. I know most of you. So Faisal is from Delhi. He's a mathematician and also a Guinness Book World Record holder. And he teaches a lot of students. I hope that's the introduction, right? And then we have Kaushal. Kaushal is from Bangalore and he is into lead generation campaign management. That's the introduction which I have been given. So that's what Kaushal has said. All right. And then we have Kumar Swami. Kumar, if you can also let us know about your... So Kumar says, I'm working as operation training QC. All right. That's great. And what part of India are you from, Kumar? And what is your understanding in terms of digital marketing? Just let us know about these two questions as well. So this is our first session, guys. And with respect to Santosh, just help me recall. You're from Belgaum. That's what you said. And what profession are you in? So you've done MBA marketing. All right. And you're presently working into... Okay, Kumar Swami, you're also from Bangalore. That's great. So we have a good attendance from Bangalore. We are expecting one more individual from Bangalore. So you're working as marketing communication executive. That's great. So that's what the Santosh introduction is, guys. And Kumar Swami says he's working as operation training QC. All right. And then we have Nitin also joining in. Nitin is from Ludhiana. Hi, Nitin. Good evening. Today, it's the first session of a new batch, Nitin. So we were just doing the introduction part. And help me just recall. So you are into the online marketing industry and you're from Ludhiana, Punjab, right? All right. So Kaushal... He's saying Sasriya Kal Nitin. All right, great stuff, guys. So just to give you a brief, it's 8:35. Let's get started. This is the very first session of Digital Marketing Paathshala's online training, where we have training of this particular course, digital marketing course, which runs for 3 months, where we have session every week, guys. And since this is the first session, we are going to start with Google AdWords. I hope most of you are aware of about Google AdWords, guys. What exactly we mean by that? I'll just open the course curriculum. I can also give you the link where you can download the course curriculum from. We had a brief introduction in terms of what internet marketing is all about. Why internet? Why do we use internet? And how the internet marketing thing has evolved. So we had a demo session this Sunday, which was just for an hour's. For an hour duration, and after that we have got a follow-up session, which is the very first session in terms of digital marketing. I'll just share across the course content, guys. So keep asking me your questions in terms of whatever queries you have. It's very important for me to make things clear to you as in when you have a doubt in your mind. All right, guys. So this is the course curriculum. I'll just share across the link with you. How can you go ahead and download it? So if you are aware about the website, which is dmpaathshala.com, on the homepage, when you go, this is the course where we are trying to learn the overall digital marketing stuff, guys. Digital marketing course. It's on the homepage. Once you click that, you'll get in the inner page, which is the specific course page. Over here, you can see download course curriculum button being there. Go ahead and click that. I'll just repeat. I hope most of you have got the access to this page. So what you can do, you can download the course curriculum by going onto this page, and in 5 minutes, I can brief you what exactly we teach in this entire course. There are different modules which are being covered in the entire course, guys. To name few, these are digital marketing overview, then you have website planning and creation, then you have search engine optimization. So with the very first one, guys, these are the couple of ones which we are going to take today. After that, we'll start with PPC advertising also. So what exactly digital marketing is, then how do we go about creating websites, how do we manage them, and what are the different kind of websites. Then there, once we talk about all that stuff, within digital marketing, there are a couple of major important topics where we would be spending more time, which is search engine optimization and PPC advertising, which is also called Google advertising. So we will, lay a lot of emphasis on the Google search ads and the banner ads. In case you are aware of that, it's good. In case you have certain doubts, you are not aware of it, feel free to ask me, guys. Then we'll also talk about another product in this overall course, which is by Google, and that's called Google Analytics. This particular product, guys, talks about, helps us as a digital marketer to understand how much traffic are we receiving on our website, from what all locations, and how much time are they spending on my website. So a lot of insights onto my website. Then we'll also cover social media marketing, where we'll study how can one as a marketer leverage the power of a social media channels. Some of the social media channels which are renowned one, can you help me name one of some of the famous social media channels, guys? Facebook, absolutely right, Faisal. Anybody else? Twitter, that's right. LinkedIn, true. Any other? All right, yeah. LinkedIn, absolutely right, Nitin. Anybody else who can name me? So Kaushal, Kumar, Santosh, Shashank, I hope. Google, absolutely. So we have Google Plus also. So these are some of the social media websites where we can leverage these websites in terms of going ahead and doing a lot of practical stuff. Absolutely. So LinkedIn, partially social media. LinkedIn is a social media, but it's a serious social media channel, Kaushal, where all the professionals go ahead, create their online profile, professional profile, and then they also interact. Absolutely, it's a professional. That's right. All right. And then after that, we'll be covering the email marketing and lead generation for business. So these are all the modules. And when we say digital marketing, if you talk about these, search engine, the third, fourth, fifth, sixth, and the seventh one, these are very important in terms of learning digital marketing in overall sense, guys. So I have the entire course module, which it's present right in front of me. In case you want to download that across, guys, I'm still sharing the link. You can go ahead, just fill up the form, and then you'll get the course details. You'll get the course curriculum. All right, so today I'm going to begin with website. So it's going to be a very light session today. When I say a very light, I mean to say not much of technical stuff we are going to start with. We'll first of all start with what exactly we mean by digital marketing. Webs, how do we go about creating a website? it's very okay. Now another question. I'll keep it as interactive as I can. I would always recommend and request each one of you to participate as much as you can on the chat window. It's a public chat window, guys. All of you can connect with each other. I hope most of you have known each other with the help of introduction I have done. We have Dhruv also joining in. Dhruv is a new member, and we have Shashank also joining in. So a couple of new joinees. And just let me help you to understand. Dhruv is from, I believe, Ahmedabad, right, Dhruv? That's what you have spoken to me, and he is into digital marketing profession already. Am I right, Dhruv? And then we have Shashank, who's from Hyderabad, I believe. And Shashank is into the web development industry. Am I right, Shashank? Yeah. Yes, says Shashank. And yes, says Dhruv. All right, guys. So, guys, feel free to network across with each other. I really recommend networking as well. I'm going to start with digital marketing overview, website planning and creation for today's session. We'll have this session at least till 10:30. So you are not audible, says Pezel. Is that for everybody? Am I audible for each and everyone, loud and clear? Yes, says Santosh. All right. Okay, Faisal has left and then he'll log in again. So he has logged out and logged in. All right, no problem. Absolutely, Dhruv. Yeah, this is our first session. All right, of a new batch, Dhruv. All right, so let's begin. I'll keep on sharing the notes also, the PowerPoint presentations, which I'm going to share in this entire course, guys. Once we are done with the class, with the session. So, okay, just give me a moment. All right, guys, so let's begin with digital marketing. I want to understand from you what exactly you mean by digital marketing. What is your understanding about digital marketing, guys? So if you can help me know in a one-liner, what exactly, all right, online presence, says Nitin. Kaushal, what's your understanding? Kumar Swami, Santosh, when we say digital marketing, what exactly is your understanding? So marketing through the digital media, and when we say digital media, what exactly we mean by that also? So marketing, Faisal says marketing using various digital devices. All right. Through laptop, mobile, all right, iPad, okay. So these all devices, smartphones and all that stuff, definitely they are something which we are very used to in today's scenario, in today's generation, but we are using it quite often whenever we have an internet connectivity. So when we have the internet connectivity, we are using a lot of digital media stuff on the internet. And when I say this digital media, I mean things like websites or blogs or social media websites. These are all digital media, and we use these digital media for marketing purpose. Why would a marketer actually use these websites? What is the reason behind these digital media being used across by marketers? There are plenty of other platforms which marketers use, just like television. Whenever there are television ads, Faisal says they are cheap. All right, I would say to get the correct information. All right, absolutely right. Right, Faisal, right, Kaushal. Santosh says specific, absolutely right. And what would be the other reason? Hey, hi, Guru Prasanth, welcome. So we just started, you haven't missed much. So what is the other reason why a marketer would actually use these digital media stuff like websites, blogs, social media, then you have forums, then you have many other things on the internet world. On the internet, what other things do you do, guys? Do you watch movies? Do you watch videos? Do you listen to songs? I mean, at all these platforms, we as, okay, let's not consider ourselves as marketers first. Let's try to understand how do we as layman language use internet. we as a layman language, layman man, sorry, we as layman man would use internet for several purposes. If I am a student, I might use it for creating, for, you know, gathering knowledge to create my project. If I'm a professional working in an organization, I would definitely, I might use it to gather information to create my, again, a presentation or my, you know, a client's presentation or something. Or if I'm a, you know, a kid, I might use it to play games, to watch movies. If I'm, you know, if there's someone who's a housewife, maybe she might use it for watching how to, you know, create certain cooking stuff for, you know, watching the recipes and all that. So Guru Prasad says, we, a marketer, use it to get leads, to get traffic. Absolutely right. Kaushal says, we can do anything under one umbrella with the help of digital marketer. Absolutely right. Nitin says, technology now getting easier to access in terms of online. Absolutely, it is easier. So as laymen, guys, I hope you all have understood how different people use internet. When they, these people use internet, their consumption pattern of overall media is getting changed. When I say overall media, there are other things like television, radio, newspapers, magazines. They all come as, fall under the purview of a media. Our media consumption has changed with the advent of internet, or with the upcoming of internet. Major focus, major consumption of internet has increased, and there has been a decrease in consumption of television. There has been a decrease in consumption of magazines, radio, and this is a fact which has been seen across. People are not watching TV as at the same frequency which they were doing it earlier on. After the coming of internet, all these, all the other media channels have gone down from, you know, in most of the cities, in most of the nations. So Mohammed Faisal says, India has second large number population after China. So large audience in India is using internet. Absolutely. The internet penetration has is going way beyond. And I hope most of you are aware what Narendra Modi is going to get in near future with this initiative of Digital India. I hope most of you have heard of Digital India initiative by Mr. Narendra Modi, where they are trying to get as much internet coverage in every nook and corner of the country. Right. All right. So Kumar Swami says, nowadays customers are using internet more than other channels. Absolutely right. Right. Thanks, Kaushal. Thanks, Swami. Thanks, Santosh. Thanks, Shashank. Right. So because of all these, the internet usage has become quite a lot. And for online, for purchasing purposes also, for making decision of what sort of stuff should I buy for myself, whether I'm a student or I'm a housewife, I'm a working woman or a working man, or, you know, a bachelor or a married man or a married woman, whosoever it is, they are buying something or the other, and their buying decisions these days are based upon all the, media consumption, the content consumption they're doing. And this consumption, the content consumption, is happening a lot on internet. So internet is the best medium to get in touch with them. That's why digital marketing plays a bigger role in that. So that's the overall, introduction, guys, I can say, or maybe I can name it as some of the importance of digital marketing these days. With the internet usage being there, marketers are using digital marketing practices quite a lot. Another best way to, reshape the entire stuff which I've said right now, the benefit of digital marketing over traditional marketing, what would be that? It's like the very first thing, guys, it's measurable. If I'm spending 100 rupees on digital marketing, I can get to know what sort of investment, of my investment, what sort of return am I getting? Am I getting 120 rupees back, or I'm getting 180 rupees back? But if you'll talk about traditional media, like spending money on radio ads or television ads or newspaper ads, it's very difficult to understand how much money, how much return am I getting. So measurable part is one of the most important factor because of which every marketer, every big brand is diverting their marketing budget from traditional media to the digital media. I hope you have seen that there's a lot of money which is getting invested by a huge number of people. And with the upcoming of these bigger websites, whether it's Amazon or eBay, who are not Indian organizations, you know, they are coming altogether into e-commerce space, and that too into the Indian audience, Indian geographic location as well. All right. So what exactly we mean by digital marketing, guys? It's a process of building and maintaining customer relationships through online activities, which is absolutely there to facilitate the exchange of ideas, products, services, and satisfy the goals of both the parties. So with the overall interaction I've just done right now with you, I know I'm at the speaking mode and you guys are at the chat mode, but still the interaction level will definitely be there. The digital marketing is all about marketers trying to make their products and services come in front of those people who are their potential audience. Giving you an example, if I am, let's say, Dell laptop, you know, I am from Dell and I am the marketing manager of Dell brand. With the help of digital marketing, when I do digital marketing for my brand, I am trying to make my brand come in front of those people who would definitely like to buy my stuff. Whether these are professionals or housewives or students who would always like to buy Dell laptops or Dell desktops. If I talk about just those products, traditional marketing helps in getting across those products and services in front of the potential customers and then doing a dialogue between them. When I say dialogue between the brand and the end customer, that happens with the help of the websites. Now, when we have a brand or a product, we always need a website. I hope most of you agree to that. The pop-ups, all right. Yeah, absolutely. So they are part of websites, right, Kaushal? When we have a website, they act as a shop for us. So if I take an offline world, if I have a product, if I have laptops to sell across, then where am I going to sell these laptops? I do need a place. I do need a shop. Within the shop, I need the electricity connection. I need salesmen to be there. I need the products to be displayed. I need the cashier to be present who can take the cash, bill the customer, and I need, the overall admin stuff. Similarly, if I need a shop in the offline world, I need a shop in the online world also, which and a shop can be an e-commerce platform or a website, in other words. A website which has a transaction where, you know, a transaction can be made as an e-commerce site. So similarly, for digital marketing, you always need a platform like a website where you can connect with your potential audience, and these potential audience can be roaming around on several places. Now, tell me one thing, guys, if I'm taking the same example of Dell and I am the marketing manager, now you guys also become the marketing manager of Dell. You guys are part of my team, let's say, and we are sitting in a, conference room and trying to brainstorm how do we get in front of our audience, which is one of the audience, which is students. Okay. So I want to target all those students who are there, who would actually buy my product. My product is, starts from 25,000 rupees and goes up to 80,000 rupees or 90,000 rupees. That's my price range for one of my Dell Inspiron laptop, let's say. Now, my question to you as who all are part of my team, my question to each one of you is, on what sort of websites will this potential audience of ours, which is the student community, do you think would be most active on? So Shashank says tech. All right. So tech websites, is that what you mean? Guru Prasad says social media. Santosh says college website. Shashank says tech websites. Absolutely right. Guru Prasad, absolutely right. Shashank, Santosh, you absolutely right. Guru Prasad says like Facebook. Absolutely right. Faisal says social media. Nitin says social media. Absolutely. So this is something which we already know that what, this particular audience sort of consume. We can definitely do an analysis or sort of a primary research also by asking, let's say, 15, 20 different students and doing a short survey by asking them what are their lifestyle pattern and how long do they actually stay on the internet. Is it 5 hours, 4 hours? And if it's 4 hours a day on an average, what sort of websites? They'll definitely have all these websites, which I know. I mean, we the answers which we have given is through our observations, right? And our observations definitely are right, but we need to really validate that also. Once we validate, then all of us, you know, which is you and you guys and me, we all being the team members of the Dell marketing department, would list down all those categories. Then after that, we will list down which all websites should we focus on. Should we focus on Facebook? Should we focus on the college websites? If it's a college website, which all college websites should we focus on? Is it the search engines where they would be typing a lot of stuff and then spending a lot of time over there? Or is it the games websites, the tech, you know, the technology stuff, or maybe some whatever kind of websites we can think of, right? So if any particular student who's trying to look for a laptop, guys, would also use a search engine to gather information about that. Maybe they might, this is my assumption also, guys. So best laptop for a student, that this is something maybe, you know, one of my potential audience might type it and guess, can you see Dell? So this is one of the example I gave you out of the blue, and that's what happened. When I said best laptop for a student, Dell's, you know, Google ad is actually present right up here, right? So this is another way, guys. We can definitely have banners or, you know, any sort of other content which is of Dell on all the websites which you have mentioned. We can surely present our banners to the students on Facebook, on other college websites or other social media websites or whatever examples which you have given. And they all were right, guys, whether it's, you know, the technology websites or all. Even with respect to search engine also, we can do a lot of promotion over here. Just to let you know, I hope most of you already know about it, but I want to iterate this fact again, that these are paid ads, guys, where we pay to Google to get our listing on the top, right? If Dell wants to be on the top for this particular query, I would definitely want my website to be on the top, right? Because I want to get in touch with that particular student who's writing this keyword. Maybe a father of a student or a mother of a student might write this kind of a keyword, or a student himself or herself would write such kind of a keyword. Now, if I am being hired by Dell as a marketing manager or a marketing executive or someone who's part of the marketing team, I have to think about these kind of keywords, guys. What sort of keywords will my audience type in? So we'll study all that. We'll study how do we do a keyword analysis. What all keywords would my audience type in? Which all websites would my audience go? And how can I get my advertisements right across over there? So another example which you guys gave me was Facebook. Let's say if I've got my Facebook open and I am not a, what do you say, I don't fall into the student segment altogether, but if you see my very first advertisement, this is so much targeted, guys. These people, Facebook, know that I am into digital marketing world. That's why they are giving me an advertisement. They are showcasing me an advertisement of one of the softwares which is into the digital world. You can see SEO, social, brand and content marketing data at your fingertips. Start a free trial today. This is by this advertisement is by one of the vendors or one of the bigger organization called Moz. This particular organization, Moz, are the leaders in search engine optimization. So they're targeting me. So all these things comes under display advertisement and social media marketing, guys. We'll cover all that part also. They use trackers, absolutely, right? Another thing, when you say about trackers, I want to ask each one of you one question, guys. Whenever you go onto a website, let's say if I go onto a website like Moz, or maybe let me take another example. If I go onto Amazon, all right, and I use I want to buy, what should I say, let's say, okay, if you see this Fitbit band, okay, I go ahead and click on this Fitbit band. This is a band which helps you to track your overall workout activity, how much calories have you burnt and all that across. All right. So if I have gone to this page, guys, that example which I am trying to tell you, let's say if I now try to open one of the product, I am seeing the stuff about this product. I am looking at the overall product description. Somehow, you know, there is a doorbell which gets ring, or my phone gets, you know, my phone rings, or maybe I say that, okay, my it's a very costly stuff. I might have to consult my parents whether I should buy this or not, whether I, you know, or I decide that maybe I'm going to, you know, buy this at a later stage. The next thing which I do as an online shopper, I go ahead and close this. Okay, once I have closed this, you might see wherever we go and open our stuff on the internet, whether it's Facebook, whether it's any other website, let's say I go onto a news website. Even if I go to a news website, this particular fit band which I had opened will actually follow me all the way. Have you ever experienced this, guys? If you see a particular product that follows you, yes, says Shashank, yes, says Kaushal. Yeah, that's remarketing. That's right, for Faisal. And yes, says Guru Prasad. Right. This is called remarketing, guys. This is, again, this is something which we'll also be studying within our entire module. Right. So this is why I'm talking about all this, because it's very important to know from the digital marketing perspective how you as a smart marketer would be building all these stuff. I would be taking all the practical stuff, guys, when you, you know, I would be giving you your free websites, and I would always appreciate you to, you know, start building your own, what do you say, advertisements using the website which I'm going to give you. So they're tracking our IP address and number of hits. Absolutely right. They're tracking our IP address. Not really. I would say they're actually installing cookies. They're in Kaushal. So this is when you have the remarketing stuff, they always have certain files which is present on their website. And when we open these websites, those files or those cookies, in other words, they get installed in our browsers. Absolutely. The you know, these cookies actually gets installed in our browsers. And when we open any other website, these cookies play their part and show us those same ads which we have come across before. So like I was saying you, whether these are search ads, guys, when I was telling you about these search ads, these paid search ads, or we'll also study how to get a website on the top for the search engine. These are the search, this website, which is on the top, is with the help of SEO, search engine optimization, or an organic listing. I would always want you guys to, you know, get your website on the top for at least 5 keywords. Create your campaigns for at least 5 keywords, whether for search ads or also to get your website on the top through search engine optimization, at least for 5 keywords. So we'll be doing practical stuff, guys. All right. So that's about digital marketing. I'll now play some, you know, talk about some more theoretical stuff before I go ahead with the practical. So why people are going online, we have covered that, for fun, entertainment, choosing all that stuff, for business contacts, for finding new employees, for finding jobs and finding employees. We've already covered that part. So let me jump on to the next slide, guys. All right. So online, cheez sasti milti hai. That's what Faisal says. All right. Thanks for sharing that. Absolutely. So if you have really experience that's great, right? All right. So over traditional marketing, what digital marketing has the advantages? We have already spoken about that. You know, the cost of sale, the bills, you know, building of the brand, it's measurable, cost effective. I've already shared that across. I don't want to spend more time on that. And what are the major ingredients of digital marketing? I've also spoken about that. The search engine optimization, pay-per-clicks, social media, email marketing. I've already done that. And I've also spoken about what are the objectives of a marketer when we're talking about digital marketing. So reaching out to the right audience, I made you understand that with the help of example of the Dell thing. So who was my audience? It was the students. My another objective as a marketer was to actually engage with my audience. So when I say engagement, How is Dell doing the engagement part, guys? Just have a look. When a student actually types on the Google search box, by best laptop for a student, and he or she opens the very first search result, which is by Dell, then this website will do the engagement part. We as digital marketers have to strategize this within my campaign, what sort of steps my website will give to the person who will come onto my website. Right, guys? Over here, you can see, now again, you know, some all of a sudden this pop-up came in. It says, would you help us to make your website? Okay, this is just a sort of a favor they're asking for. If I say no thanks, this was one engagement. And after that, another engagement which they're trying to do is by giving me separate products with separate, motivation. So these are the best sellers, they tell me. And they also tell me about the student offer. And once I, let's say, click on one of the products, the interaction happens automatically. When we say interaction, I mean, I'm not talking to the website totally, but the website will keep giving me some or the other button to go ahead and interact. So I had the, the products. So that was one interaction where I clicked on one of the products, guys. Now this is second interaction where I go ahead and I have the option. So we always have to provide an interactive, some option to the end customer. So buy online is another button. I have another way of interactivity. If you can see, you have buttons like features and designs, accessories and services, ratings and reviews. There is no dialogue exchange which is happening between me and them. Definitely there can be a customer support where they might be having, which is an online customer support. But if that's not there, still the website should have all the possible information which my audience would like to gather across. So that's what I mean by interactivity or the engagement. Whenever we are running a campaign, guys, we should first of all try to understand what sort of things would my audience be like to know about. So all that stuff should be present. So that's about engaging the interactivity stuff. Then the third step, in terms of the objective, not just reaching out to the audience, engaging the audience. The third is also to motivate the audience. What sort of motivations you think we can give to the student who's looking out for that product? What sort of motivations can we, absolutely right, the offers, says Guru Prasad, Shashank says offers, and these can be discounts, these can be some extra stuff, discounts, offers, right Guru Prasad, right Faisal, right Kaushal, the EMI option, right Guru Prasad, absolutely right. I hope each and everybody is participating, that's great stuff. Okay, and the next one, another objective besides the motivation is also that we as marketers want our efficient spending on a campaign, right? The gifts, absolutely right, Faisal. When I say efficient spending, I have to always get, when I say I am the marketer, I am the marketing manager or the marketing executive, whosoever you tell me in the department. I have to take approval from my top management in terms of the marketing budget. I'll definitely need people to help me with the marketing stuff, whether it's spending on the Google ads or whether it's hiring some SEO professionals or hiring the email marketing guys, hiring content writers. All these are kind of expenses for the organization. When I make a request to the organization that I need a 1 lakh budget per month or I need a 1 crore budget, whatever, I'm just giving an example. Once I do that, the top management will ask me what sort of results can they expect out of 1 lakh rupees. Then I have to tell them that my budget can give me these amount of clicks and these amount of clicks can really help me get these amount of leads. When I say leads, with the clicks resulting into people saying that yes, we are interested. Let's say with 1 lakh rupees, I give them a approximation of 1,000 clicks I'm going to get. With 1,000 clicks, maybe 100 people are going to contact me or 200 people are going to contact me. And out of 200, just 50 people are going to buy from me. And these 50 sales, on an average sale, would be somewhere close to 40,000 rupees. So 40,000 rupees per sale into 20 sales would actually go somewhere close to 8 lakh rupees. With 1 lakh rupees spending, 8 lakh rupees of revenue will get generated. And out of 8 lakhs, if I talk about the profits, let's say even if it's 25 or 30% profit, somewhere close to 2.5 lakhs or 3 lakh rupees is the profit. So all in all, 200-250% is the ROI. So return on investment, efficient spending is something which is needed. Kaushal says number of hits, as I told before. Absolutely right, Kaushal. Right. So the hits, the clicks, and the sales is definitely which is needed. So a digital marketer, if a digital marketer know which is the right platform to utilize for marketing across a particular stuff, where the their audience would be, and which particular channel will give them good hits, relevant hits, quality hits, quality traffic, and would result into sales, then that digital marketer will do wonders for the organization, and organization will do wonders for them in return. All right, so that's about the digital marketing goals, guys. In the end, you have to really look after generating leads, generating sales or leads, capturing leads from customers who are searching for their answers or the products or the brands they are searching for over the internet. So that was about the objective, guys, from a digital marketing perspective. I want you to keep all these in your head. Whatsoever digital marketing activity which we'll talk about in our entire course, whether it's SEO, whether it's email, whether it's social media marketing, whether it's Google search ads, whether it's banner ads, whether it's remarketing, whatever we are going to learn in the next 10 session, guys, all these objectives needs to be met. Otherwise, there is no point in learning digital marketing and doing digital marketing for either for ourselves or for the organization which we are going to work with. All right. So Kaushal says, sorry, I told you I'm in office. I'll have to move. All right. No problem, Kaushal. I can share with you the recording link and then you can also view that. No problem, Kaushal. Thanks a lot. I really appreciate for you for taking out time. All right. Thanks a lot. So when we go ahead, guys, what all other things form part of digital marketing? All right. Kaushal, you can exchange numbers with others in case you want to in private chat or whatever. All right. So digital marketing involves a lot of stuff. We have already spoken about it, whether it's videos, websites, social media sites, emails, games. I don't want to go. All right. Thanks. So I don't want to go ahead and talk about all of them again. And okay, next thing. Thanks, Kaushal, for sharing it with everybody. What is inbound and outbound in bringing traffic? All right. So this is inbound and outbound. Inbound means pull digital and outbound means push digital. So let's talk about this now. Anybody who can help me knowing that? So I've got a very great question. I want to take that. And I've just given the answer as well, that inbound is all about pull marketing and outbound marketing is all about push marketing. I would definitely answer that, but I want you to give it a shot, guys. Anybody who can help me in knowing. Santosh, Guru Prasad, Shashank, Faisal, no idea, says Guru Prasad, no problem. I'll take that. At least reply, guys. Santosh says no idea, no problem, I'll take that. No idea, says Shashank, all right. Faisal, any idea? All right, no problem. So inbound marketing has a different name, which is in pull marketing. All right, no problem, Faisal, if you're leaving for Namaz, no problem. You can, I'll share the recording link with you. So feedback is pull marketing. Good, great guess, Nitin. Pull marketing, feedback is majorly, not a form of a marketing, I would say. But I really appreciate that you tried. Let me give you an example. Same example, let's take that. If I am a student, all right, if I am a student and I need a laptop for myself, and I go ahead and type this keyword, a query into the search box, which is best laptop for a student. When I press this, Dell's search engine paid search ad comes over. Now, what is Dell doing for me? Dell is actually pulling me. Dell is doing inbound marketing. Why is that inbound marketing? Because, okay, this is an example of a pull marketing, because Dell is not approaching me. Dell is just getting in front of me. They are pulling me. And how would they push it? How would they do an outbound marketing? Let's say if again, I am a student and I get a call from Dell that, hello, sir, today, I am from Dell and we have got to know that you are from such and such college and we are have a promotion going on. Would you like to buy this? And I don't have a need for it, right? I have never made a request for it. Or even if I made, I have not given them permission to go ahead and call me up. If they're doing it, they're pushing it. They're pushing it. They are not pulling me. If they have got certain, within their search, their ad, it's not actually contacting me. That's the difference. Or examples of inbound marketing are major parts of digital marketing, guys. Just like whether it's social media, whether it's search ads, which I have shown you, whether these are banner ads, or let's say whether these are video ads, or when all these things which come in front of the audience, where we make our product in front of the audience, we pull them, we attract them with our good banner. But if I am sending something without taking permission from them, I have taken their email data from somewhere, I've taken their phone number from somewhere, I'm pushing them, I'm giving them a call without taking their permission, sending them an SMS, which is a sort of a spam. All these spam things are part of outbound marketing. We receive a lot of calls from credit card department, loan agency, to get a lot of the loan stuff and all. That's all push marketing or an outbound marketing. But if I need something and that particular product comes in front of me, then it's an inbound marketing which they're doing. They're pulling me. They're inbound marketing or pull data. Okay, I have a very great question by Santosh. Is email marketing push marketing? If I go onto a website, Santosh, let's say, I go to the Dell website, giving you from the same example, I am a student, I go to the Dell's website, punch in my email address, and I click on the checkbox which says I have fully read all these terms and conditions, and I give permission to Dell to send me newsletters, promotional mailers, blah, 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 and then I go ahead and submit. And whenever this, absolutely, I'd subscribe to it. I've subscribed to their newsletter or their promotional offers. When Dell sends me across emailers after capturing my data, then that's not a push marketing, all right? That is a pull marketing only, because the permission has been taken. The only difference is that a permission-based marketing or a non-permission-based marketing. If permission is not taken and Dell buys my data from somewhere or the other, tries to spam me across by sending an emailer, then that's push marketing. They are pushing me to please come to my place, take my product, I'll buy your product and buy my product, I am the best, right? But if I get an email saying that you have subscribed to on our website on such and such date, and these are the certain offers which we are coming across. I hope everybody is clear on the push and the pull difference, guys. Or the inbound or the outbound, in other words. Yes, says Guru Prasad. Yes, says Kumar. Yes, says Santosh. All right. Shashank, I hope you are also clear on that part. All right. Yes, says Nitin. All right. Yes, Shashank already said that. All right. Thank you so much. That was push and pull, or the inbound, outbound. Why digital marketing? We have covered that part as well. Because, now we are on the second largest. The population is increasing. People are spending a lot of time on internet and they want to buy stuff in a one click away. We all know that. I don't want to spend more time on that. So now what do? We utilize this stuff with so many agencies, so many brands, using these platforms and doing a lot of marketing. So these are certain stats, guys, which have been taken by Group M study, which says that 4 out of 10 people uses social media, so searches a lot of stuff on social media. 5 out of 10 people uses social media and then go back to the search for more information. And 7 out of 10 people uses search engine with social media as well, social to make them more confident in the decision they made. So all in all, you know, it's about the usage stuff, just information. Let me move ahead. Okay, it says, how can you be successful when you are, you know, getting into the digital marketing world? You just have to make your brand visible, more relevant, be more congruent. When I say congruent, it means a similar stuff. You have to be crisp, clear, and relevant. So, you know, if you're talking to the point, it's making sense. And then also be searchable. When we say be searchable, if somebody's typing your about, you know, the product or services which you are also offering, let's say if somebody types, you know, restaurants in New Delhi, let's say, or restaurants in West Delhi, and I have a restaurant in West Delhi, then I should make my brand searchable for those right keywords, right? And if I say relevant, I need to make sure my brand is talking to those people who are my potential audience. I have to talk about the same content. So we'll come across, you know, we'll talk about all that stuff. How do we create the visibility with the help of the search ads or the non-search listings also? So that's that was the introduction about digital marketing, guys. I hope most of things were known to you already, but if even couple of things were new to you, it would have been a valuable thing. The next thing, guys, is the type of websites which I want to talk about before we get started with Google search ads today. You know, the Google paid search ads. What sort of website? So what exactly we mean by a website, guys? I know I have already share that across with you. We have already spoken that like the way we have an offline store, we also need an you know, something in the online world. What is about retention in digital marketing? All right, retention is a term which means that if I get an audience, if I get a particular customer, Nitin, then I have to retain it for a longer period of time. And to sell to get leads. Okay, you have answered about the website stuff. So why do we want that? Absolutely right, Guru Prasad. And to answer your question, Nitin, retention is all about keeping your product, keeping all your customers intact with you and making them do repeat purchases. You retain them for a longer period of time. You never want any of your customer to come to your online store or offline store or whatever business model you have and just come to your place once, buy your product and never come back. You need the retention stuff, and you do a lot of retention policies. You need to create retention policies by offering them again discounts or all these other offers with the help of emailers or other sort of communications telling that you are a valued customers. You are one of our valued customer. We would like to give you such and such kind of stuff. Makes sense, Nitin? Does that answer your question? So Santosh says it's a global platform. Do we need? All right. So when I say about types of websites, we all know what websites are. So websites are sort of a, in the internet world, we have World Wide Web where every day there are n number of web pages getting created. A web page is like a digital content which is placed on the internet. Absolutely right, Guru Prasad. It's static and dynamic. Different kind of content placed across on the internet forms a web page. Either if it's a multimedia content like images or videos or different written content like a written text, all these things add up together with, you know, some menu on the top or footer. I hope you guys are aware of these terms, the footers or the all that stuff. they form a website. Now, there are different websites. One which Guru Prasad have already answered, that there are different kind of websites which we can say like static or dynamic. Okay, let me talk about the static or dynamic website example. Can anybody, so let me know more about static and dynamic websites. What is the difference between static and a dynamic website? So Guru Prasad says static is like a government website, all right? Right. Any examples, Santosh, Nitin, Kumar Swami? Shashank says dynamic. Okay, Santosh says dynamic websites keep on changing. Absolutely right. That's the right definition to it. Shashank says dynamic websites have regular updation. Absolutely right, Shashank. Shashank, Santosh, both of you have said that right, like blog. Anything which keeps changing, absolutely dynamic, changing the content. Something which is static, which remains there for long, which doesn't get changed, is a static thing. Just to give you an example, absolutely, some of the government websites are static. Or maybe if you have, I don't know which year you guys started using internet, but might have been 98 or 2000 or 2002 or somewhere like that. When we started using internet, in the initial years, most of the websites were static, guys. There were no changes on the websites being made for ages and ages. When I say ages and ages, I mean for months or for years. Giving you an example of some of the dynamic websites, if you see the news websites, you know, these portals, even with the social media websites, they all are dynamic. They keep changing. Nitin says, in dynamic, interactivity is also there. Absolutely. In dynamic, there's a lot of interactivity feature also which is being enabled. Just like you have news on the top and within underneath the news article, you can always put in your comments. You might have seen that. Even e-commerce portal, absolutely. Within the e-commerce portal, you do have the interactivity stuff, and a lot of new products come in. A lot of old products are being deleted across. So I hope most of you are aware about these. And some other classification of websites. I don't think I need to spend a lot of time on this. So let me move ahead since all of you. Technically, what's the difference? So technically, the interactivity definitely is the difference, Santosh. You know, most and use certain, sometimes, you know, set rules that whenever there is something new, that, you know, a new content is being punched across, that website has a lot of features in it. Otherwise, I would say a static website, just like if it's a 5-pager website, it stays there with those 5 pages with the same content, but the platform can be same also. With same technology, a static and a dynamic website can also be made. There is something in URLs. Yeah, in URLs, absolutely right, Santosh. With static website in technical terms, URLs can never be changed. But with the dynamic websites, if you have a URL right now of a particular web page, you can anytime change that, rename that to whatever you want to name it. You can rename the, you can rewrite the content also. But with static websites, if a content has been written, that either gets deleted or a new web page gets created. Earlier, even creating a new web page was a big task, but right now we hardly have any static websites. If we talk about examples or any website, even a small little website is made dynamic these days. So with respect to URLs, it's the renaming stuff, you know, which where you cannot do with static, but with the dynamic, you can always rename, you can change the URLs. All right. Yeah, making device website fill to all the device. That's called the thanks for getting this point across, Guru Prasad. So Guru Prasad says making website fit to all the devices. Now fitting your website to all the devices would mean a responsiveness of the website. What exactly responsiveness means, your website opening up properly on a mobile device, on a tablet device, on a laptop or a desktop, that's called a responsiveness. And your website also opening up perfectly on different browsers. On different browsers, whether it's Google Chrome, Mozilla Firefox, or Opera Mini, or Safari, or whatnot. So portable, this is the portability or the responsiveness. These are the two names, guys, which you can actually say, portability and responsiveness are two things which is very much needed these days in whatever sort of websites you go for. Now, like I said, I'll be giving you your free website for you. And these websites are going to be responsive and portable both. They would open properly for all the devices, whether it's a tablet or a PC or an iPad or an iPhone or a BlackBerry or an Android or a whatnot, whatever you name it, and for all the browsers, guys. Okay, now there are two ways through which we can classify them, these websites. One is on the functionality and another is on the purpose. With respect to functionality, we have already spoken about the static and the dynamic. So static and the dynamic, I've already taken that. So content is dynamic, information gets changed. It takes longer time to develop our dynamic websites and a lot of coding needed. Some of the various languages which are being taken are PHP, ASP.NET and Script. Guruprasad says, I hope we need a developer to make responsive. Yes, I would be using certain themes, Guruprasad, and these themes are actually responsive by default. So I know most of you are not developer except for Shashank over here, and all my audience who study digital marketing, they are from the non-technical background. In case you want to learn digital marketing, you really don't need to be from the technical background, guys. That's what I promote. And whatever tools I'll tell you, whatever techniques I'll tell you, 80 to 85% of your dependency on developer would not be there. And in case your dependency is there on a developer, let's say for the remaining 10-15%, I'll teach you things in a certain fashion that wherever you go, whether you work for a client, you work as a freelancer, or you work for any other organization into the digital marketing department, you will be in a position to give the developer the right guidelines, the right direction on what all things needs to change, how things needs to be formed up so that your marketing campaign can run perfectly and deliver you the desired results which you want. Hope it makes sense. All right, so the responsiveness also I've already spoken about. All right, thanks Santosh, thanks Guruprasad. Responsiveness is opening your website perfectly on the desktop, laptops, tablets and all that. That's from the functionality point again. Based on the purpose, now this is something exciting, guys. We have personal websites, so I'll give you personal websites for free with your subscription to this course. And then we have certain informative websites. When we say personal websites, these websites can be like, I have my personal website, I'll showcase you. You have your own stuff being talked about in your website, which says that who you are, where do you come from, what's your overall background like, and what is your experience altogether, maybe your personal profile, you want to talk about your skill sets, your experience, if you have certain achievements, you want to talk about any tools you or certain portfolio, any sort of portfolio where you want to list down some of your works, so and your contact details. All right, thanks a lot, Guruprasad. So these are some of the things, this is how a personal website looks like, guys. Then you have informative websites. Any example of an informative website which you can tell me? Can I have, all right, sure, I'll share that. So informative website, guys, any example? So let's say NDTV.com, all these news sites, they are also informative, or maybe a technology blog, or maybe I'll tell you a couple of websites from where you should always, even the CNN website, the TED, absolutely, educational website, absolutely. I also wanted to tell you about a couple of websites which you as a digital marketer, in case you are looking to build your web career into digital marketing, you should always visit and read a lot of stuff from these websites. Maybe since it's beginning for you guys, so there would be like a lot of things which might not get clear to you when you read things on these websites. ISEDC is a more or less an e-commerce website, I would say, Guru Prasad. So it does provide you information also. Absolutely. It comes under informative and e-commerce both. So search engine journal website, guys, search engine watch, in case you guys are planning to build your if you're very serious about building your career into digital marketing. These are some of the websites which keeps publishing a lot of new content into the industry. So I spend at least half an hour daily on this. If I don't get time, then at least I try to catch up on the new stuff which they have mentioned. So you can see today's is 13th of July, and they have got certain new stuff which says Google Map users can now share maps from desktop to mobile according to a recent Google Plus post. I know most of many things won't be clear to you, but somewhere or the other, if you will start, it will make sense to you. I'm not sharing a lot of other websites which are there on the internet because it can make you go crazy. It can also confuse you a lot. But these are the only three websites which I always recommend to my participants and students. So informative websites, you have already given examples. Some of the business websites, like let's say the Infosys website. So I suppose Guru Prasad works for Infosys, right? So you have TCS or any sort of business, you know, any organization, let's say Nestle, let's say Lenovo.com, let's say Dell.com, Microsoft.com. These people have their own website, and these comes under business websites. Then we have e-commerce websites. I don't need to focus on that. I hope most of you know that. Any website which lets you buy stuff, do a transaction. So we had gone onto the Dell website. If there is a buying mechanism, I can enter my credit card or debit card details and I can buy stuff. Then an e-commerce transaction happens, and these form under the part of e-commerce. Some of the renowned names being Amazon, eBay, Flipkart, Snapdeal, and whatnot, Zabong.com, or all these are e-commerce sites. And then we have social networking sites like, absolutely right, Nathan. Then we have social networking sites. Most of you know that. I don't want to spend more time on that. Let's get started, guys, with the very first stuff, which is Google AdWords. Now, Google AdWords is a part of search engine marketing, guys. When I say search engine, first of all, why do we use a search engine? What exactly is a search engine? Anybody who can help me understand the meaning of a search engine? It's very important for me to, first of all, it's very important for me to understand whether each one of you are clear on what exactly a search engine is. Why do you guys use a search engine, or what exactly a search engine is for you? So Google, Yahoo, Bing, these are the name of renowned search engines. Absolutely right, Santosh. And Nitin says to find out anything, that's the reason why we use a search engine. Absolutely right. And Guru Prasad answers platform to get information to the various websites. So that's the answer of what exactly a search engine is. Absolutely right. To search something. So you guys have answered me what exactly it is, why do we use it, and which all the renowned search engines. So which all the renowned, Santosh answered Google, Yahoo, Bing, and why we use it, Nitin answered to find out something, and Guru Prasad answered what exactly it is, which is the platform. It's a platform to get information. Absolutely. So it acts as a mediator. Absolutely. Shashank says it's a tool which actually allows user to get the relevant website according to the query. And this query, I hope most of you know, whatever query I have, let's say I want to buy an iPhone 6. This is a query in my mind. I write that query, which I have in my mind, within a search engine. And this query in internet marketing is called a keyword, right? And if a keyword is pressed across this is my favorite keyword. I generally take this as an example. Thanks, Guru Prasad. So whatever query I have in my mind, I always write that across on Google search engine. Why do I do that? Because I trust Google, And I trust Google as a search engine. And we all know, you all have already answered, a search engine is a sort of, in other language, in other example, if I tell you, let's say in whatever college or school you have gone into, you might definitely would be having libraries out there. Within the library, you have a lot of books with a lot of information being there. When you enter into the library and you know that you need information about the topic ABC and you want to understand where can you find information about this topic ABC, now you have a huge library with a lot of database right across. How do you find, where will you find this? Now you talk to someone, you would have spoken to someone and or maybe you have a internal mechanism in your library where you can find the categories, you know, which all categories of books are there. So you get to know that this particular topic is from the business category, business books. You go to the business section. Now you have, first of all, narrowed down your search. You have eradicated all the other books and then just got into the section of business books. Now within the business books, you get to know that this particular topic might be known across to a particular author. You look at the author's books and you get hold of the right book where the information is given. So a search engine is just like a library where there's a lot of database being stored across of so many websites. Whenever a new website gets created into the World Wide Web, gets stored into the data center of search engines, and a search engines always list out the relevant results from their data center to the user of the search engine whenever that user types in a query or the keyword. Absolutely, that is called crawling. Whenever, so I'll tell you what exactly crawling means, guys. Right, you answered that it's asking the librarian. You would ask a librarian or the names. Absolutely right, Santosh Guru Prasad. So I hope most of you are clear on that. And when this keyword is being typed across on the search engine, the two ways through which a website comes on the top is with the help of an ad. Right, so you have apple.com who has come on the top right away by creating an ad. And this is what we'll start working on today, guys. And the second module is going to be about the organic listings, which is through SEO. I hope most of you are clear on the categorization. These three results, which you can see on the top, are with the help of one of the product which Google has, and that's called Google AdWords. Google has a lot of products. Google has Google Search Engine. Google has Google Maps. Google has got another product called Google Play. Then Google has another product called Google Translate, Google Analytics. Absolutely right, guys. Similarly, Google has another one of the favorite tool or one of the favorite product for an advertiser, which is Google AdWords. With the help of Google AdWords, absolutely, you have AdSense too. Thanks, Shashank. Thanks, Faisal. With the help of Google AdWords, an advertiser or a brand owner can get their website on the top of the search engine for a keyword which they want to. Why will Amazon want to get their website on the top with the help of these ads? You can see only three ads are there, guys. I'm not hearing your voice. Guru Prasad says that. Guru Prasad, can you log out and log in again? All right. So in case you're okay. Okay, good. You can hear me. So I'm saying when you can see only three ads on the top and there are no furthermore advertisements, only one yellow ad, only one search ad listing, which has the ad symbol in yellow. Then you have the second search listing, which has the ad symbol in yellow. You have the third search listing on the top, which has the ad yellow button. But why not in the bottom one? Because that's the way it is, guys. Google doesn't display more than three search ads on the top. So you have maximum three top search results being the maximum in a particular search engine result page. So I want you to understand what a search engine result page is, which is also called a SERP, guys. Let me take another browser. Within my browser, whenever I do a search, the very first page, guys, which opens up is called a SERP. Can you see this is one of the search engine result page? Now I have set it up to 100 search results. This is one SERP, SERP 1, then you have SERP 2, search engine result page. I hope most of you are clear on that. And within an SERP, I have also told you the top three search listings. These are search listings. Top three search listings can be the ad ones. Sometimes not all the three are there. Sometimes just only one. A lot depend on how many people are trying to get their advertisements for a particular keyword. And on the right hand side, if you can see, you can see another search ads, you know, these text ads being there on the right hand sides. It's written only once as the ad, but all of these are ads only. When I say ads, all these people, whether it's Flipkart or Ask Me Bazaar, they are paying to Google to get their advertisement on the top. When I talk about side ads, guys, maximum 8 is which is permissible, which Google allows on one search engine result page, on one SERP. I hope you are clear on the SERP, what it stands for. I hope you are clear on the maximum limit on the top, maximum limit on the right hand side for the text ads. All right, thanks, Santosh. Can everybody let me know whether you are clear on these aspects? Yes, says Santosh. Yes, says Guru. Yes, says Shashank. Yes, says Kumar. All right. So 8 on the right hand side, 3 on the top is the maximum for one search engine result page. There can be less, but that's the maximum. And then you have the online shopping ads over here also. You can see it says sponsored ads. These are a bit expensive, guys. And maximum which you can see over here are also 8 shopping ads on the right hand side. So even that has a limit to it. Now, how does this process happen? How do you go ahead? Let's say if I am Amazon, okay, I create this search ad. I'll tell you how do you create these search ads. I create the search ads and I tell Google that for whenever someone types in this keyword, are the display ad? So are these display ads? No, these are not display ads. These are shopping ads. It's called, these are shopping ads and display ads are different. I'll come on to that. Thanks for asking, Guru Prasad. So shopping ads and display ads are two different ones. The shopping ads always appear on the search engines only, but display ads appear on third party websites. So the point which I was trying to make, when Amazon has created this ad, okay, Amazon has created this ad and that they have created with the help of Google AdWords, guys. We'll log into that. Once that's been created, Amazon gives a permission or instructs Google that please make my ad visible on the search result whenever there is this query being typed across by anyone, and that too for a specific region also. It can be for a specific region. So when I say region, it can be, let's say, India on a national level. Whenever someone types a particular keyword within India, all right, the IP address gets detected by Google. In India, whenever someone types this keyword, Amazon's advertisement should be there. Now, Amazon ad can be on the second position, can be on the first position, can be on the third, or can be on the fourth. When I say fourth, can be this one. This is a fourth position, guys. So that was first, second, third, and then the fourth, Ask Me Bazaar is on the fourth position. Then it's fifth, sixth, seventh, or there can be some more. Now, what would be the idea, what would be the objective of Amazon? Won't Amazon, or if you have Flipkart, who is on the seventh position, won't they fight for the first position? You have Apple on the first position. Won't you guys want also? You have a video lag. All right. I'll be a bit slow on that. So you have Apple on the top. All right. Then you have Amazon on the second position. And then you have MySpark price on the third position. All right. And on the right hand side, you can see you have Ask Me Bazaar Depends on quality score. Absolutely right, Faisal. I'll take that. On the right hand side, you have fourth position being acquired by Ask Me Bazaar right now. Then you have some other website on the fifth. Then you have sixth with some super smart deal. And then you have for seventh, you have Flipkart. Now my question to each one of you, let's say I am with Flipkart and you guys are with Amazon. And me being with Flipkart, I am on the seventh position. What do you think my idea would be? Would I want to be on the top first position? Or is it only just Apple which will want himself or herself to be on the top? Absolutely. Now, since we want ourselves to be on the top, the top position gets acquired by those people, those websites who are able to maintain certain quality score and also a bid level. I'll talk about what exactly a bid level is. So bidding plays an important role and the quality score. Absolutely right, Nitin. You recall that. So let me first make you understand what is a bidding and what exactly is a quality score. Let's start with bidding, guys. So Santosh, Guru Prasad, when we are working, and Shashank, when we are working on the Google AdWords, it's for each and everyone. We always tell Google that I am ready to pay 50 rupees for every click someone makes on my ad. Now, Amazon will always get charged for their advertisement, for placing their advertisement Amazon will only get charged whenever someone clicks on their advertisement. Till the time there are no clicks on the ads, there would be no money deducted from their debit card or a credit card. Credit card or debit card gets attached to the Google AdWords account. And there is a certain budget which Amazon will let Google know that I want to spend only 500 rupees a day and not beyond that. All right. Bidding. Right. So 500 rupees, let's say, excuse me. Right. Excuse me. So let's say I tell I am Amazon. So you will teach that technically. So yeah, absolutely. I'm going to open the AdWords account right now. I'm not just going to let you go away with the theoretical part, Santosh. So coming on to, I'll just open the Google AdWords account also. If you'll see my past videos, you will see I teach with the help of the campaigns. All right. So if Amazon has given instruction to Google that I have got just a budget of 500 rupees and I'm ready to pay 50 rupees per click. So I have sort of, Amazon has set a bid, 50 rupees. All right. Similarly, even Flipkart, which is on the seventh position, will also make a bid. You guys, we all of us are competitors. Yes, one of you become Apple, one of you become a flip an individual from Flipkart, another person becomes an individual from Snapdeal, another individual becomes from any other organization. So we all would not be knowing who is bidding how much. All right. But with our bids, with person with the higher bids will always given preference and will always be on the top. But not just the bidding, there's another thing, guys, which is called a quality score. Quality score for every keyword gets counted, and I'll show you in Google AdWords account how it gets displayed. I'll first of all show you a Google AdWords account which is already made up for one of my clients. And over there, you can see the advertisements which are made. And along with advertisements, you can see quality score for every ad. For every keyword, the quality score is made. Let me just open that. A quality score is always given out of 10, guys. And quality score is measured on with three different parameters. You can write that down in case you want that. I'll give you the notes as well for that. Let me tell you. The very first thing on the very first parameter on which quality score is measured, one is the ad copy quality. All right, this is the ad copy. When I say ad copy, you can see this is, let's say if I take the Amazon ad, this is a headline, guys. Then you have a URL being here. I hope most of you know what exactly a URL is, which starts with www, absolutely the landing page. All right. And then you have a description line. So you have a headline, then you have a description line, then you have a description line too also. I'll come on to this. These are called extensions, guys. We'll create these also. So first parameter for a quality score, Google tries to give you certain marks for the ad copy quality. Your ad copy quality matters a lot on the kind of English writing you have done and the kind of words you have used. Are they really talking the same language which your end URL, your end web page or the landing page? This is also called a landing page, guys. Whenever someone clicks on this ad, the web page which opens up or the web page which where the end customer lands is called a landing page. So is the ad copy in aligned, is aligned with the landing page? That is one parameter. So ad copy quality. Number two is the landing page quality, guys. The text or the content which is written on your landing page, is it aligned with, first of all, the keyword? And after the keyword, is it the ad copy? So the keyword, the ad copy, and the landing page. Are these three things? The keyword, the ad copy, and the landing page, are these in a line? So the landing page quality is definitely taken into consideration. Is, you know, are things really kept in proper fashion? So we'll talk about how, what all things should one do when it comes down to creating a landing page. All right. That is number two. And the third thing, guys, is called CTR. Anybody over here who understands this word CTR? I hope Nitin would be knowing about it. So what is, so third thing which, you know, where the quality score matters is called, absolutely right, Santosh. It's called click-through rate. Absolutely right, Faisal. Right. So most of you know that. So that's great. Shashank, are you aware about the click-through rate? All right. You are. Great. Click-through rate, guys, is calculated with a formula called number of clicks upon number of impressions. Into 100. Absolutely right. That's right, Guru Prasad. I'll just showcase you the click-through rate for a live campaign, first of all, before I begin and try to create a new account. And from the new account, if I go ahead and start creating an ad copy, a campaign or everything, I first want to showcase an existing campaign or existing account of my client. Okay, let me take another, all right, let me take this example. So I know many things would be sort of sounding French to you. You might be looking into this for the first time. For some of you, it's not. For some of you, it might be, right? So let me just first of all go to the keyword section and show you, or let me go to the ad section. So I'll go definitely step by step, but I want to showcase you the click-through rate stuff and all that. On a campaign level, if I go and I will show you the click-through rate for the campaign level. Can you say number of clicks, number of impressions, number of, you know, the overall CTR, the price part and all that, that's being mentioned over here, the cost. You know, a lot of data is covered over here. So just focus on the clicks part, guys. I'm just highlighting that, the impressions, the CTR. I hope most of you are aware of what exactly an impression is. If in case you're not, let me know. Once your ad, yes, says Faisal, all right. Santosh, I hope you're also aware of that. Shashank, an impression. All right. Let me just reiterate that again still. An impression is something, once your ad appears, is an impression. I have entered a keyword as a user on search engine. The ad appears. For all these three people, one impression has got counted. If I do a refresh again, a second impression gets counted. More impressions are getting recorded for them in their separate individual Google AdWords account. But if I click only on the Amazon one, so for Amazon, there would be two impressions in one clicks. And for the other ones, it would be zero clicks and two impressions. Again, zero clicks and two impressions for MySmartPrice and for Apple, the first and the third one. So Faisal says, aapka ad SERP mein kitni bar aaya? I'm not really getting your question. Which ad? When you say mera ad, which ad are you talking about? For which website are you talking about? And which position? So when I type buy Samsung phone, Guru Prasad says, how many times is ad appearing? Yeah, absolutely. That's what impression is, right? Okay, Faisal, you are also trying to tell me about the impression part, right? I think that was not a question, but that was a statement which you made, right? All right. So that's how a CTR thing, which you can see. I can also show you the advertisements which I have got created. When I type buy Samsung phone, then ad appears on SERP. Which ad for which website? Are you asking a question or are you making a statement? If you're asking a question, let me know, please. Can you see the advertisements, the kind of advertisements which we see on the search engines? They are like these only. You have a headline and then you have a description line one, description line two, then you have a, you know, URL, all that stuff. That's how it appears, right? So that's how an advertisement looks like. Now let's get started with the new ad, guys. What is mobile? Okay. Mobile is like if this ad is made to actually appear on the mobile device. So we can even select that. Let's get started with creating an advertisement, guys. And I would want for each one of you to create advertisements for yourself. I would be giving you your separate websites. For your website, you can create you know, advertisements for keywords like, let's say, internet marketing professional, maybe with your particular location and you want to target, let's say, if in case you are in Ludhiana or you are in Hyderabad or you are in Bangalore, you are in New Delhi or you are in Belgaum. So maybe digital marketing professional in Bangalore, internet marketing professional in Belgaum, such kind of keywords. For such kind of keywords you can create. Let me go ahead and create a new account, start helping you with creation. Right, I hope I answered your question, what is mobile? So when you can also select for which particular device do you want to go ahead and create your, show your ad across. So I can only make my ad appear only on mobile device. I can also make my ad appear for a specific audience. Does anybody have a new Gmail account which you want to share across? I can go ahead and I think you did that, Guru Prasad, right? You created a new Google account, right? In case I give you the presenter rights, would you? All right. So what I am doing right now, I am taking one of the volunteer right now. I'm giving the presenter rights to Guru Prasad and I will keep on instructing, giving the directions, and we'll do a live demo with a practical, right? So I'm giving you the presenter rights right now, Guru Prasad. Your screen would be visible to each and every one and we'll take it from there. My voice would be there along with Guru Prasad's machine team. All right. You want to give me the Gmail ID? I don't want to do it because the IP address can get changed. That's why I want you to actually go ahead and do that. Would that be fine? if I make you the presenter, or you want me to only do that? Okay, so a yes is for you want me to do it, or I give you the presenter rights. All right, so Guru Prasad, I made you the presenter. All right, yeah, so you can accept it, and then let's take it from there. And I would encourage each one of you, Shashank, Santosh, Faisal also, to go ahead and create your ads and then showcase that across to me. Let's do a live demo now. Okay, so we can see the window. You're not able to hear my voice. I think you can, because okay, now you can, because I was not saying something at that point of time. All right, so you can go and please enter adwords.google.com, guys. You can do that along with Guru Prasad as well, in case you can just type. All right, so yes, you can do that by just typing AdWords. The very first search result which you see, you can go ahead and create, enter into that. I hope, yes, your screen is getting shared and we can see your screen, Guru Prasad. Just go ahead and sign in, guys, with your new Gmail account. I would encourage you guys to use a new Gmail account, because I would be using certain, I would be giving you coupons to actually run ads. So I will try my level best to give you a coupon. I hope, Guru Prasad, this is a fairly new Gmail account. Yeah, so okay, yes, Santosh, do that. So I think, Guru Prasad, that's your earlier old Gmail account that I... All right, you're on the speaking mode, Guru Prasad. Yes, you can go ahead and talk. So can you log in to your new Gmail account? All right, so Shashank, Faisal, if in case you guys also want to do it, you can create a new Gmail account and then create an AdWord account, and I can help you with a coupon also. So you want to see the demo and then do it. All right, sure. Please see the demo and then do it. No problem. So we are doing it right now. I'll keep on guiding and how it's getting done. All right, so this is the first screen, guys, which you will see. It will ask you to create your first campaign. Go ahead and click on the create your first campaign on the left hand side, please. All right, so okay, I'm taking the control of the overall system now. So let's create one of the very first campaign, which is I mention it as okay, Guru. I think you gave me the control, but later on you didn't. So just go ahead and type a campaign name. Let's say Guru SEO Services or just Digital Marketing Services. Let's say if you're promoting yourself as a digital marketer. So maybe you can write, Guru SEO Services is what you can. Okay, first of all, you would have to take, can I take control of your keyboard and mouse? That's what I did earlier on. I want to do it. I would do it quickly. All right, so I did send you across the. I'm not getting the option right now. Earlier I was getting an option to take request from you. I'm sorry for that trouble, but I can't really see that thing across. Okay, you can just continue doing that, no problem. I don't see that. Okay, now I have the control. So PPC means pay-per-click, guys. All right. So if I say Guru PPC Services, that's the name of my one of my campaign which I want to create. I want to go ahead and promote that across. On the right hand side, I would take all features because I want to show you each and every feature of the campaigns. I go ahead and do all features, and in the type part, we are learning the search network only. So we'll go ahead and click on search only, right? We are not doing display. Display would be the second part, guys. I'm going to change the campaign name. It got changed because the type part. That's what you do next. When we'll scroll further down, we are going ahead with all features. By default, the networks part, you have to always include the search partners. Now, what exactly search partners are, guys? Search partners are like Gmail or, okay, why search network only, Santosh? Because as of now, we would be doing, no, there's nothing to do with Bing. Bing and Yahoo doesn't come with Google. The search partners are like Google Maps or Gmail and all. No. These are their competitors. They don't have a partnership now. They had partnership that was way in the past, Faisal. So why we are doing, Santosh, to answer your question, why we are doing only search only? Because we are trying to learn the text ads which are there on the search engines. All right. The display ads would come at a later stage. When we say display advertisements, they are like banner ads which are there on the third party website. So let's say that would be step two. In our next session, we'll do the display part also. As of now, I want to showcase you the search network only. This would be display would be in the next one. All right. Something like, you know, let's say if Guru Prasad's website has to be promoted on naukri.com. Okay, or let's say on ndtv.com, we can place a banner on naukri.com with the help of the display part. But as of now, these are text ads which would be aligned with the keywords only. And whenever a keyword gets placed on the search engine, then the advertisement will get appeared. Makes sense, Santosh? So search ads are only those text ads which are there on the Google search engine only. Any ads which are there on the search engines are the search ads. Any banner ads, which are also called display ads, are not on the search engine, but on the third party sites like NDTV, Ask Me, or maybe, you know, NDTV.com or Naukri.com or whatever, whichever websites we want to talk about. We'll talk about that also in our second session. Does that answer your question, Santosh? All right. We have to, by default, we can take the search partners. In case you don't want to do that, you can remove that also, but I generally go for that. In case you don't want to do it, you can exclude that. It's all up to you. Your, if you include that, in your advertisement can also appear on Google, Google Maps, Gmail. All right, I'll go slow. All right. If you include search network, then your ads will also appear on Gmail, on Google Maps, and such kind of sites which have partnership with Google search engine also. So some other websites which Google has. Now with ad, okay. Yes, please, right. All right, so should I go further down? So we'll be taking all these things later on. As of now, I want to, why I have selected all features, because I want to show you all the features and not the standard features. Once we go further down with networks, you can see we have excluded that. With respect to devices, you guys asked me for the mobile version. As of now, by default, when we are making an ad, this option is not visible. I mean, it's not, I'm not able to edit it, but once I'm able to make the campaign, then I can edit that later on. All right. So as at present, it will be shown, my ad will be shown on all the eligible devices, whether it's tablet, whether it's whatever, what do you say, tablet, desktop or something. All right. Then the next thing is, guys, locations. Let's say I want my ad to appear for just Bangalore location. I can go ahead and write that. And you can see Bangaluru being there. I can go ahead and add that stuff. Then there is another option which is called a radius targeting. I can even include entire India, and I can even include a particular city, or I can go ahead and click on nearby and do a radius targeting, guys. Now, if you see the radius targeting option, within the radius targeting, you can see within, so I can select whether it's a mile or a kilometer. Let's say if I do a kilometer, this is the major, central point of Bangalore. I say I want to cover 40 kilometers from the center point, and I go ahead and do the search part. All right, it has shown something else. Oh, just a sec. We had to mention, so 40 kilometers, for, sorry, 40 had to be written over here, and Bangalore had to be written over here. So what it has done, 40 kilometers of the entire radius from the central location it has selected. All right. I can go ahead and do that, but I don't want to do it. I was just trying to show you. Other thing which I want to show you, let's say if you have a local business, let's say Guru Prasad has his own digital marketing services, which he is trying to sell, and he wants to focus only on specific location. All right. Within Bangalore as well. So, do you guys know of the zip codes within Bangalore? You can write that. Can you help? So, okay, I can click on this button. If you can see, it shows available locations for inclusion or exclusion. within the map area. I can go ahead and click that, and can you see this particular specific feature lets you focus on not just the entire city, but within the entire city, you can just mention which particular colony you want to target across. Make sense? Try that across. I can go ahead and include the colony which has the zip code 560068, and I can go ahead and add that across. I can remove the entire location, which is Bangalore, and just have, I can zoom in, and you can you see whether it's Indira Nagar I want to target, or whether it's JC Nagar I want to target, I can go ahead and do that. Make sense, guys? Guys, give me just a couple of minutes. I have to just use the washroom for 2 minutes. I'll be back. So go ahead, Guru Prasad, with this. I'll be back in just 2 minutes. So go further down and play around. I'll be back in 2 minutes. All right, guys, I'm back. Sorry for that. So once you're done with the locations, then we'll scroll further down. Similarly, guys, you can go ahead and select whether you want to go ahead with the entire city or just with the nearby location. Right? Makes sense. You can either remove this, the Bangalore part, and I would suggest you to focus on specific colonies within that. Then you go further down, it asks you for the languages. So English is something which is the most common one, but if in case you're trying to target people who use other search engines, other Google search engines in different language, whether it's in Chinese or Hindi or Urdu or Swedish or Thai, you can even go ahead and do that as well. But we'll be taking example of English only, just to make things very simple for us. Now the next thing which you can see, it's asking for your a bid strategy. In the beginning, we will do only, I will manually set my bids. I will tell you about the what all changes can we do with bid strategy. There are different bid strategies, guys. We'll talk about that in detail. But as of now, we want to set bids ourselves, and we don't want to give control to AdWords. The very first option says, I want to set manually, the bids for myself. The second option says AdWords will set my bids. I don't want to give this to AdWords, because if you're learning, why do we want to give permission, the authority to AdWords to keep changing my bids? Default bid, let's say, there is no rule as such on what bid we should actually keep it. Initially, when we are doing for the first time, we can do it at a random bid, whether it's 20 rupees, and I want to go ahead with a budget of, let's say, 500 per day, or maybe just, let's say, 1000 per day is the kind of a budget. I'll just change the bid to 55. I can change these things at any given point of time. All right. Then we have a delivery method. I want to make you understand one thing about delivery method. Are we clear on? Okay, Santosh, you're clear on that. So the bidding part. Faisal, say that again. Are you asking a question or saying a statement? I'm not clear on that. If you're asking a question, can you let me know your question? Guru Prasad and Santosh, I hope you're clear on that. So the delivery method, there's a mistake in setting the bid. $550, okay. I can, all right, thanks so much. Yeah, 55, it should be 50, right. That was a very high bid, okay, thanks, all right. So I have set it manually. Default bid is 55 rupees per click, which is I have set across, and my budget, I have set it to 1000 rupees. Now, next thing, guys, which it says is delivery method. I want to make you understand what exactly we mean by that. Let's say if my budget is 1000 rupees and my per click cost, which I have set, is 50 rupees. So for every day, what is the maximum number of clicks as per you, which I can receive? For 1000 rupees, 50 rupees is the per click. Maximum 20 clicks I can get in a day. With 1000 rupees budget a day and 50 rupees I'm willing to pay for per click. So what number of clicks in total I can get in maximum? 1000 divided by 50 is 20, right? Faisal says 20. Is that understood to Guru Prasad and Santosh? So with my total budget, which I'm willing to pay, which is 1000 rupees, and I'm willing to pay 50 rupees per click. So with 1000 rupees, I can buy how many clicks? Just 20 clicks, right? If I'm paying 50 rupees a click, 50 rupees for one click and 20 clicks in total will end my budget of 1000 rupees. Now, why I was asking this is because Guru Prasad and Santosh, you guys are clear on that, right? The delivery method says, if you want, all right, thanks Santosh, Guru is not typing because, okay, the screen is shared, all right. The delivery method, standard and accelerated means whether you want your 1000 rupees to be divided in the entire day. Let's say your keyword which you have set is are very competitive and they are being typed across by various people, okay, within the geographic location which we have, which you have set. Let's say in the Bangalore region, your keywords are typed by 5000 people in a day. And your ad starts running from 12 midnight to, from 12 midnight till 11:59 p.m. For 24 hours, your ad runs, okay? Now, once your daily budget starts at 12 midnight, when the day starts, your ad starts, and after 1 hour, or, since the competition is very high, many people are typing in this keyword, you get 20 clicks within in 1 hour. All right. Since your keywords are very much searchable in the geographic location, then you would be like, oh my goodness, 20 clicks got consumed and I had a lower budget, which is 1000 rupees. How do I make sure? How do I get to know whether my, audience which have clicked on that were serious audience or not? I want my advertisement, you say that, with my 1000 rupees, I want to make my advertisement run throughout the day. And when I say throughout the day, it should be balanced across, you know, on different time zone, on different time of my day. You know, for certain hours, it should run for the morning hours. For certain period of time, it should run for the afternoon hours and then for the evening. And so your 1,000 rupees, even if it's a lesser budget for the keywords you have chosen, and when you select standard, still your 1,000 rupees will be divided or evenly divided throughout the day. But if you do select on accelerated, the moment your ad will run, it will be shown across till the time your budget gets exhausted. With standard, what will happen, your ad will start. For after 2-3 clicks, your ad will automatically will not be shown and stopped for certain hours, for certain period of time. Then maybe after a couple of hours, it will start running again by Google. Google will start run it again in the afternoon hours. After 5-6 clicks, it will still stop. And then it will start after again couple of hours, maybe in the evening, it will show. Your 1,000 rupees will be splitted across throughout the day, will be evenly optimized. With accelerated, there is no evenly optimization. Santosh says, how would you know the target customer has clicked? Yes, we will get to know that. Within the reportings, whether your target customer, okay, so is your, how many people have clicked? We'll get to know that, Santosh. Whether it's 50 people who have clicked or 5 people who have got clicked. With every click, there would be a reporting. But whether it's a genuine customer who has clicked, a targeted customer who has clicked, or a non-genuine customer who has tried to play around and just kept on clicking, that can also be known with the help of the leads you will get. If people are clicking on your ads and they're not your target customer, then maybe you are not getting right kind of leads or purchases. So that can be known, but with respect to the number of clicks in all, whether whosoever clicks it, you can get to know that. But with respect to whether the right person has, all those people who are clicking on it are right on right customers or right target audience or not, that will get clear with the help of certain analysis we will do with the kind of leads which we are going to receive. Make sense, Santosh? Does that answer your question, or I can still go ahead and answer that? All right, thanks. If it does, good. In case not, then you can surely ask me again. I really encourage that. Ad extension is a bigger topic, guys. I will take that in next session, and I will talk about all these extensions. What exactly are these? So the ad extensions are majorly more things which gets clubbed into your ad. All right. Today, my major focus for today's session was to cover up the digital marketing and the types of websites. But since most of your knowledge level was good in that part, that's why I started with the Google Ads also. I wanted to do that. So I hope the settings part majorly have that. The location part, location targeting is clear to you. The language was simple. And the bidding part, I have set it manually, and with respect to budget, you are clear on that part. And if I go further up, the language, location, with respect to location also, you can go ahead and select the particular colonies. You know, you can select the colonies as well. That was clear. And also, I hope the difference between search and display is clear. So I'll take all the other things also in detail. Let me go further down. As of now, you can let the ad extensions part be blank. When you click on schedule start date, end date, you can set the start date and end date for your advertisement. So let's say you don't want your advertisement to run for Saturdays and Sundays. You know that your audience is not going to be so active on Saturdays and Sundays, and you can expect some stupid kind of people clicking on your ads. That's why you run it from Monday to Friday. And you also have a sense that your audience will generally look for your kind of services whenever they are in their office hours. Whenever they are in office, probably then they would look for your what do you say, kind of services. They will search for your kind of services. So you can set a timings. You can select the start date and end date in that regards. So if you click on the end date, let's say you want to start it from 13th July and you want to run it till 31st July, that is with the respect of that date, guys. But within that, you don't want to include the weekends. So that's why you can create an ad schedule. Do it Monday to Fridays only. And you want to run it from 10 a.m. in the morning, let's say till 6 p.m. All right. You can even do something of that sort, let's say 10 a.m. to 1 p.m. and again Monday to Friday, you can select whether you want to run it from now 2 p.m. So from 1 p.m. to 2 p.m. you don't want your ads. You think that within the lunch hours, they might not be looking for your advertisements. So I mean, it's all up to you. How do you want to take it? Let's say from 10 a.m. to 1 p.m. you have run it, and that's the ad scheduling. Then you have ad delivery and ad rotations part, where you would, whenever you're creating your advertisement for the first time, which we are doing right now, you always go ahead and optimize for clicks, guys. All right. You optimize your ads for clicks. Once your ads, let's say, run for 10, 15 days, I will tell you how to set up conversions. You know, what are conversions? Whenever there is a sale or a lead being captured, or let's say if somebody has whatever your objective of the campaign, there are different objectives of your campaign. Either you are looking for the end sales with the help of, you have an e-commerce site, you have got the products listed up and you are running ads to sell across your products. Or if you don't have an e-commerce site, your conversion can be, let's say, just people filling up your form and trying to give in their personal details so that you can call them up. So your campaign conversion can be measured with the help of the form fill-ups. With a scenario to a campaign conversion can be measured with the help of the purchases which will happen on your e-commerce store. You can also have another kind of conversion in a scenario 3, where you call a conversion when someone signs up on your website. Or a fourth kind of a scenario can also happen when you count a conversion when someone comes on your website and downloads a particular ebook or downloads a software. So different businesses will have different kind of websites, and these different websites will have different kind of conversions. I'll showcase how do you create conversions as we'll move forward with our future sessions, guys. So to begin with, once you're done with ad scheduling, go with ad delivery and ad rotation and click for just optimize for clicks. Forget about the optimize for conversions. I don't recommend these ones. Rotate evenly and rotate indefinitely. The most perfect one is optimize for conversion. You always give idea to AdWords, this overall mechanism. You tell them that you want your advertisement to be shown across to those people only whose chances of getting converted are maximum. Then you can go ahead and ignore these things, guys. Dynamic and campaign URL options as of now. These are for way too big, websites, and they need, a coding stuff to be done. When it comes down to creating advertisements from the scratch, from the beginner level, and to understand everything, these are the overall settings. The next thing to do is save and continue. So as of now, campaign URL options, these are advanced settings which you do for various big websites. All right. So once you have created a campaign, that was a campaign, guys. The next thing is an ad group. So you have a campaign, which is a bigger thing, and then you have ad groups underneath that. You can go ahead and create your first ad group and start writing headline, description line 1 and 2. I'll take these in detail in the next session. It's 10:40. I don't want to keep you waiting. It's already 10 minutes up. So let's go ahead, and I would like to encourage each one of you. So Santosh, Shashank, Faisal, Guru Prasad, to go ahead and create a new Gmail account first and play around with these things, which I've already mentioned with respect to the settings and all. And I'll give you a website. So why not an old account? An old account will not accept a coupon. I will try to enter a coupon for your website. So you might get help in that case. Make sense? A new account will only accept a coupon. All right. So can I wrap up this? Wrap up today's session, guys? I hope it was. It did make sense. Let me just take back the presenter rights. All right, so guys, I just wanted to understand. I hope it was. How can I download the recordings? I'll give you this. I'll send across the recording link to you, Santosh, and to each and everyone, and you can go ahead and get that. So let me take the. I'm not able to get the controls back. So Guru Prasad, you can remove yourself from the presenter, which is perfectly fine. All right, no worries. So I'll share the recordings with you guys. Right. Thanks, Faisal. Thank you, Guru Prasad. And thanks, Santosh. Thanks a lot, Shashank. I hope it was a valuable session for you. Let me know your feedback for today's session, please, on the chat. Anything else you want me to take through WhatsApp or to go to meeting? I'll send you the link on your WhatsApp. Oh, it was awesome. Thanks a lot, Faisal. Appreciate it. Shashank, did you get some value out of today's session? Was it helpful? It was an interesting session. All right. Thanks a lot. Can I create ad to this account? Absolutely, Guru Prasad. Go ahead and create an ad and I'll book a domain for you. You can use that domain. All right. Great, Shashank. Absolutely. Demo ad. Absolutely. Go ahead and do that. All right. Santosh, any feedback from your side? Any things which you want me? All right. Thank you so much. Guru Prasad, any feedback from your side, please? Would encourage. How was the session today? Was it valuable? How can I optimize the content for SEO purpose online? All right, so that will be covered in the SEO module for sure, Faisal. And we'll take that in detail. All right, it was. So Faisal, your question would definitely get answered when we'll start with the SEO purpose thing as well. All right, great thing, great stuff, guys. Thank you so much for your time. It's 10:45. I've already gone ahead with 15 more minutes. I don't want to keep you waiting. Have a sound sleep, and I'll keep you updated. So probably we'll meet next Monday again, and we'll take this forward. All right. See you then. Take care. Bye now. Good night.